Beloved of God, have you ever wondered why there are about close to 8 billion people on this planet, and yet there is only one you? Have you ever looked in the mirror and told yourself that you are average, inadequate, or not enough? If so, then you are not seeing yourself the way God sees you. If you are not seeing yourself as God sees you, I have a message for you. We are all created unique and special. God, my friend, is the potter and we are the clay. He made us all perfect, having our own uniqueness. Some people have blue eyes, others have brown eyes. Some people can do this and some people can do that. Some people are right-handed and some people are left-handed. However, you appear, you were made for a purpose, and that is why you are unique, my friend. Do you know that there is only one person who thinks the exact way you think? And that person is you. There is only one person who looks the way you look. There is only one person who processes things the exact way you do. There is only one person who works out and exactly the way you do. Who chants the way you do. Who acts the way you do. Who breathes the way you do. In fact, my friend, there is only one you. And that makes you special and unique. The Bible says in Psalms, the 139 chapter, the 14th verse, that for you formed my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, and I know these very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth. When you take a moment to really think about the fact that you are unique and look like no other person, and no other person looks like you, it gives you much confidence to live a life that is not subjected to the influence of others in trying to be like someone else. It is a beautiful way to think of life. My friend, it sets you free from comparisons, just knowing that there is only one you. Never give into the lie that you are anything less than the most wonderful reflection of our glorious God, who is worthy of honor and praise. Remember, my friend, you are made in the image and likeness of God. So, just as David did, give God all the glory and praise because of how fearfully and wonderfully He has made you. See yourself that you are unique and that you are beautiful, and none can be compared to you, and that this uniqueness is your power. It's your strength in life. It is your advantage. There is no one else like you. You are the only you that God has ever created. You have no copies out there. God, my friend, made you to be a special, distinguished, and a unique person. Every single person is a masterpiece of God. Think about it. There are close to 8 billion people on the planet, but there is no one else with your fingerprint or with your retina scan. You, my friend, are unique. You are an original design. You're a masterpiece. You are priceless, a priceless work of art. It is because God is wonderful that we are wonderful. So, in Ephesians, the 2nd chapter, the 10th verse, the Bible says that for we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. When you look at yourself and everything that makes you, your giftings, your anointings, and your talents, you should stand in awe of what God has created in you. You, my friend, should thank Him and honor Him for everything He has given you and the gift of life He has bestowed upon you. God prepared good works for you and me to do in this life, and discovering what those good works are can be a lot like a treasure hunt, a thrilling adventure to uncover who we are and what God has called us and uniquely gifted us to do. Dear child of God, this is a profound truth, and I want you to embrace it every day you wake up. Speak to yourself that I am unique and looks like none other. And you need to embrace that every day. You must say it again and again to yourself. Oftentimes, I hear a lot of people tell me, "Oh, how I wish I was like my brother. How I wish I was like that sister. I wish I was like my friend. I wish I was like my cousin. I wish my lifestyle was like my good friend or my great friend," and so forth. "I wish I had my stuff together like so and so." But hey, child of God, let me tell you something. You absolutely are unique. You, absolutely unique, beautiful, and amazing being that you are, you are unique. And it is about time you know that no one can live like you, and you can't also live like any other. Your fears, your insecurities are all uniquely you. The things that you thrive at, that you are completely confident about, are all uniquely you as well. Beloved, hear this. Until you accept how beautiful and unique you are, you can't rise to accomplish your greatest potentials. Nothing in your life will ever work out the way it is supposed to work out. I know that some people have high cholesterol, or you are fighting blood sugar issues, or you've got a severe issue in your lower back, or your stomach is not as strong as other people, or may have challenges in your health. That's okay, because it is all uniquely you also. And embracing your unique self means embracing everything about your unique self, both the good, my friend, and the bad. I know it is so easy to talk the self-love talk, but so many people fail to walk the walk. Say to yourself that I am unique, and you will appreciate how much your uniqueness can bring into your life. I have discovered that many look down on themselves and think or wish they were like others. But child of God, there is a reason why you are like who you are, and why there is none who look like you, both genetically and physically. The way to embrace your uniqueness and maximize your potentials is to love yourself. How many of you truly, really practice self-love every single day? How many times a day do you actually embrace the unique, amazing, beautiful you? Beloved, understand this fact, that life is about creating the most unique, amazing version of yourself. So, why would you spend any time fearing what other people think about this unique, amazing person that you are? Every single day, my friend, I take a look at my life, and I take a look at the journey that I have been on, and all the time I've spent on planet Earth, and I think to myself, of all the billion people in this world, I am uniquely me. There is none like me. Oh, this is so amazing. Child of God, I want you to know that there is a reason why God has created you so different and unique, and that you are built specially for a unique and a divine purpose. You have the inner ability that makes you different from all other persons. You are designed differently and uniquely for a purpose. There is something God wants to achieve with your life, and the amazing thing is that only you carry what it takes to make that which God wants to do with you a reality. And I am talking about you. Yes, you, my friend. And I know that sometimes you look at yourself in the mirror and think you are not who you wish you should be. You may be slim, short, tall, big, fat, or anything. And I mean anything. You may even have a disability or a health challenge. But hey, guess what? That wasn't an accident. God knew about it even before you were born, and he saw that these things can't stop his purpose for your life from manifesting. God, my friend, prescribed every single detail of your body. He deliberately chose your race, the color of your skin, your hair, and every other feature. He custom made your body just the way he wanted it. He also determined the natural talents you would possess and the uniqueness of your personality. So, however you may appear, you, my friend, are the one God wants for that particular plan he has for your creation. You are not an accident. You are not a mistake. In this life, it is the difference you bring on the table that makes men seek for you. If men can find what you offer from somewhere else, they will find a reason to ignore you. It is only when what you offer can't be gotten by any other person that men will begin to embrace you and reward you for your difference. Your difference, my friend, is in your uniqueness. And I want you to understand that it is your uniqueness that can sell. Don't look down on yourself because of anything. The Lord has a reason for your uniqueness. Embrace it and maximize every bit of opportunity your uniqueness attracts. And you, my friend, will live a beautiful and a fulfilled life here on earth. May God bless you.